Today, I'm going to show you how to turn the default cube into this cute little fella. This is a Muggo. Muggos are little critters I like to make to practice basic modeling and extremely simplistic character design, and I think they'll make a great exercise for beginners. In this series, we'll cover basic modeling, basic materials, and a simple render setup so that you can start making little Muggos of your own. So, let's get started.
Modeling!
For once, we're actually going to start with the default cube. And weirdly enough, the first thing I'm going to do to the cube is to turn it into a sphere by hitting Ctrl and 3 to add a subdivision surface modifier with 3 subdivisions to my cube.
Why not just use a sphere,
you ask? You'll see why in just a minute. I promise it'll make sense shortly. Next, I'm going to scale up my round shape a bit, and then I'll hold Tab and select Edit Mode so that I can make some changes to its shape. If holding Tab doesn't bring up this pie menu for you, just go to Edit, Preferences, Key Map, and make sure that Tab for Pie Menu is checked. Then it'll work. It's a small thing, but it saves a lot of time. Now that I'm in edit mode, I'll make sure I'm in face select mode by clicking on this button up here or hitting 3 on the QWERTY part of my keyboard, not my numpad. Then I'll select the top face and hit S to scale it down a bit. I'll make sure I'm on the modifiers tab and then increase the subdivisions to 4. I want to make the bottom of my shape a little more square, so I'll select the bottom face and hit Shift E, then move my mouse to make it more square. Notice that as I move my mouse, the edge colors are changing to a more purplish color. This is called creasing, and it's invaluable for modeling. It lets you determine how hard or soft an edge should be on objects with subdivisions. To make my ship a little taller, I'll select the top face, hit G to grab it, then Z so that I move it in the Z direction, which is up and down. That seems good. I'll hit Tab and go back into Object Mode, then I'll hit 1 on my numpad to go into Front Orthographic View. I want to add the eyeballs now, so I'll hit Shift A to open the Add menu, navigate to Mesh, and select the UV sphere. It's hidden inside the first shape, as you can see from the outline. I want to move it to the front of my shape, so I'll hit 3 on my numpad to go into Right Orthographic View. Then I'll hit G to grab, and then move it to the left. I'll hit 1 on my numpad again to go back into Front Orthographic View, then hit S to scale the eyeball, followed by G to move it into roughly the right place. It's important that I do this in orthographic view because it ensures that I can only move in 2 dimensions, left to right or up and down. If I were to try grabbing it and moving this eyeball in the regular perspective view, it would make it a lot harder to place it quickly. Let's go back into edit mode so we can see why we wanted the UV sphere. Notice that at the top of the sphere, there are a bunch of concentric circles. We can use these to easily create the iris and pupil of our eye. But first, we need to have the top of the sphere facing forward, so we'll go back into object mode, select our sphere and hit R to rotate, followed by X to rotate it on the X axis, then 9 and 0 to rotate it 90 degrees. R, X, 90. Now the part of the sphere with the circles is looking straight forward. I'll hit 7 on my numpad to go into top orthographic view, then hit G to grab and move the sphere closer towards the body. I'd like for there to be 2 eyes, so I'll go into the modifiers tab and search for mirror. Select it, then navigate to the object option here, click the dropper icon, then select the original shape we made. This will make it so that the eyeballs are mirrored relative to that shape. To get my body shape to be smooth, I'll need to apply the subdivision modifier. The old shade smooth option is gone in Blender 4.1, but since I'm done editing the basic shape of the body, it's fine to apply the modifier. I'll then select shade smooth by angle, and uncheck keep sharp edges. Now my fella is nice and smooth. I'll tweak the eyes a bit for now, and I'll make lots of little tweaks as we go on. Next, I want to add the legs. So I'll hit Shift A to open the Add menu, navigate to Mesh, and select the cube. I'll hit G followed by Z to move the cube down below the body. I'll hit Ctrl 4 to give my cube 4 levels of subdivision, making it nice and smooth. I'll hold Tab and go back into Edit Mode, hit S followed by Z to scale my leg vertically. Then just as before, I'll make sure I'm in Face Select Mode, and I'll select the bottom face and scale it down a little. I'll hit Shift E to crease the bottom of the leg and make it just a tiny bit more square. I'll tab back into object mode, hit G to move my leg down a little so I can see what I'm doing, then tab back into edit mode and crease the top of the leg a little as well. I'll tab back into object mode, then press S to scale down my leg, followed by G to grab it and move it into position. Just like before, I'll go to the modifiers tab, apply the subdivision modifier using the drop-down menu, then add a mirror modifier and I'll select the body as the mirror object. And then I'll select my leg, right-click and set shade smooth by angle to get a nice smooth result. Alright, I'm fairly happy with the base of my little Muggo, so I'll hold Z to bring up the viewport shading pie menu and select Material Preview, because it's time for
materials!
To add materials, let's navigate to the Materials tab. Click on the plus button to create a new material slot, then click on the button marked New to fill the slot with a new material. I'll double-click the material name to rename it and call it Body, I'll then go to the base color selector and choose a yellow orangish color, then crank the roughness all the way up. Then I'll select the legs, go to the material selector drop down, and choose body from the list to apply the same material to the legs. Next, I'll select the eyes and follow the same steps to create a new material. Hit the plus button for a new slot, click the new button to fill that slot, then double click to give it a name. I'll call this one eyes, then I'll create two more materials the exact same way, a blue one for the iris and a black one for the pupils. Next, I'll tab into edit mode so we can start to apply these materials. To make a bunch of fairly precise selections quickly, we can hit C in edit mode to enable circle select, which looks like this. We can use circle select to quickly select the faces of the sphere that we want for our pupil by left clicking and dragging it around. But unlike the regular selection tool, you need to right click to finish making a selection with the circle select tool. If you don't right click, the tool will remain active and you won't be able to do anything else. So hit C, make your selection, then right click to confirm that selection, and once you right click to confirm, the regular selection mode will be active again. Now that I've selected some faces on my sphere, I'll go over to the materials list and select pupil from the list. Then I'll hit assign to apply that material to the selected faces. As you can see, once I hit assign, the faces turn black, just like my pupil material. Now I want to make a selection for the iris, so I'll zoom in a bit. Then I'll aim my cursor to the right side of any face immediately outside the pupil, like here. I'll hold Shift, Alt, and left click to select the entire band of faces surrounding the pupil, then go to the materials list, choose iris, and click assign. Now we have an iris. And since I want my eyes to appear shiny, I'll turn the roughness down on each of these materials until I'm happy with how shiny they look. I'm happy to have them be really shiny, so this looks good. I want to give this Muggo a coat, and now's a good opportunity to explain why I wanted a round cube instead of an actual sphere. If I select the body and tab into edit mode, you'll notice the thicker line here near the bottom. I want to use that line to help me make the shape of the coat, and a regular UV sphere wouldn't have that line there. We're going to use the geometry that's already here as a base to make our coat. To do that, I'll hit 1 on my numpad to go into front orthographic view, make sure I'm on face select mode up here, then hold Z to bring up the viewport shading pie menu and select wireframe. This'll let me see all the way through my object, which is handy when you want to make a selection that goes all the way around. Since I want to follow a curve with my selection, I'll go over to the selection tool, then click on it and hold it until I see this pop-up. I'll choose select lasso from that list, then I'll carefully trace the outline of the coat on my Muggo. If you miss some faces, it's better to change your viewport shading to solid or material preview in order to select them, because making selections in wireframe shading will go all the way through the object, like this. So I'll hold Z to switch to solid viewport shading and then finish making my selections for the shape of the coat. Then I'll hit 1 on my numpad for front orthographic view, I'll hold Shift and click on the faces I want to deselect. I want the front of my Muggo's coat to be open, so I'll deselect these faces in the front symmetrically. Once I'm happy with the shape of the coat, I'll hit Shift D to drag my mouse away to duplicate the selected faces, then hit Escape to have the duplicate faces return to their original position. Then I'll hit P to bring up the separation dialog, and I'll choose Selection. This option will make a new object out of any selected faces, and now that I've separated them, I have a perfectly sized coat for my Muggo. I'll tab back into object mode, and as you can see from the orange outline, there's a new object there. I'll go to the Modifiers tab, then I'll click on the body and hit H to hide it from view. Now I can see the shape of my coat, and I'll rename it, and the eyes also. I'll unhide the body by hitting Alt-H, then I'll go over to the Modifiers tab, select Add Modifier, and search for Solidify. Then I'll go to the Thickness slider and move it to the left until I'm happy with the thickness of the coat. That looks good. I want my coat to be a brown color, so I'll go to the Materials tab, hit the minus button to remove the body material from the list, then hit the plus button to create a new material slot, and then the new button to create a new material, and I'll call it Coat. I'll then choose a nice brown color and increase the roughness so it's a lot more matte. I'll go back to the Modifiers tab and apply the Solidify modifier. Then, to smooth the coat out, I'll add a new modifier, search for Subdivision Surface, and set the subdivisions to 4. Now I want to add some eyelids, so I'll select the eyes and hit Shift D to duplicate them, followed by Escape to have them return to their original position. Since these duplicate eyes are in the exact same spot as the original eyes, we can just hit S to scale them up a little and have them be eyelids. To better see what I'm doing, I'll go into the Materials tab and remove all of the materials by hitting the minus button until they're all gone. Then I'll go to the Material Selector dropdown and choose Body from the list. Next, I'll tab into Edit mode, hit A to select all, then just like before, I'll hit R, X, 90 to rotate the sphere 90 degrees on the x-axis. I'm rotating it back so that I can get a clean cut across the nice flat lines in the middle here. I'll hit 1 on my numpad to go into front orthographic view, hold Z to switch my viewport shading to wireframe, make sure I'm on face select mode, and change my selection tool back to the select box. Next, I'll select the bottom half of the sphere, like so, then hit X to bring up the deletion menu and select faces. I'll tap back into object mode, then hold Z to switch shading to material preview. Now we have some eyelids. Because the eyelids are in the same spot as the eyes, we can also rotate the eyelids to help us make expressions. So I'll hit 3 on my numpad to go to right orthographic view, then hit R to rotate and move my mouse until the eyes are open a little wider. The eyelids don't yet have any thickness, so just like the coat, I'll give the eyelids a name, and then I'll go to the Modifiers tab, search for and select Solidify. I'll move the Solidify modifier up in the stack by dragging on this grip here. That way the Solidify will work properly when applied. Sometimes the order of modifiers matters, as you'll see in a second. I'll adjust the thickness of the eyelids until I'm happy, then I'll apply the modifier from the drop-down menu. To smooth the eyelids out, I'll add a subdivision surface modifier just like before, but notice that when I apply it, I get this error here. That's because the subdivision modifier wasn't the first in the stack. Like I said before, sometimes the order matters. For now, the eyelids look fine though, so let's move on. I'd like my Muggo to be a little derpy, so I'll select his eyes, hit R to rotate, followed by Z to rotate on the Z axis, then I'll move my mouse until the eyes derp a little. Nothing major, just a wee bit of derp, then I'll select the eyes and the eyelids, and adjust them by hitting S to scale and G to grab and move. And that concludes part 1 of this Muggo series. We'll pick up next time to do some costuming by adding the hat and some more clothes, so stay tuned for that. If you learned something from this video or you like the content, you know what to do. Also, feel free to come hang out on Discord, the link's in the description. All my love goes to my patrons, without whom I could not make these videos, and a huge thanks to the Deuces Club for always sticking around to the end of my videos. If you weren't already in the Deuces Club, you are now, and if you want to join the Deuces Club members list that I pin to every video, just comment Deuces down below. Alright, that's it for today, I'll be back soon with part 2. Deuces!